Hey loves, how you going? It's your friendly burlesque are about town. If you don't know me, my name is Grace Cherry and I am a burlesque performer and an instructor here in Hobart, Tasmania, Australia. So I'm right down the very, very bottom of the globe, which is appropriate for someone like me. So I have been uploading some burlesque tutorials each Friday, and today this week has just been a nightmare and I couldn't get in the studio. So look, I'm straight from my home, literally giving you a burlesque tutorial today, and I thought we'll do something fun, a little bit cheesy, a little bit naff, and do a routine to the I Am a Good Girl song from the movie Burlesque. So hot take, I would say the burlesque movie has this much to do with burlesque, but it's got Cher in it. So it's great by all standards. So what we're going to do today is a little warm up, get a couple of bumps and grinds kind of going and flowing, just to break down some of the moves that I like to use. And then we'll put it in a fun routine and run through it a few times. But of course, the beauty of being at home, you can do this as many times as you want. So yeah, slightly dodgy light setup. I've tried to have it going. It's maybe a little bright. And this is a routine you don't need any special equipment or anything like that for. So just make sure you have enough space to pop your arms out. Small children, dogs, cats, chuck them away. And let's get started. I'll get some tunes going and we'll start with a cool little warm-up. And of course, you could pop any other background music on you like. I just like something chill when I'm warming up. Amazing. So just take your feet about hip width apart from me and just bring your arms up and down. I always say that a warm up is great for two things. Either you are someone that has run around all day. I know you've got small children, or you're in a very caring role, or a real organizer, and this is your time to breathe. Come back in. You know, this class is going to go for 40, 45 minutes. It's your time, right? Otherwise, you could be someone like me that spends a bit of time hunched over a computer or a phone, and this is a great way to start to open up your body. Exhale. Inhale, exhale, give you one more big deep breath in and out. Now we're going to take some side stretches. So pushing your hips side, center, and it's like you're trying to touch each side wall with your hips. That is way more important than how deep the arms go. It is much better to have a good straight line than to have your arm really far over and like blocking your face. That's really not giving you any sort of stretch down the side body, you know, up under the armpits. If this hurts your shoulders at all, you can always cut hands to shoulders or even hands just under the hips, pushing side to side. Don't worry about looking like sexy right now, we're just moving. And give me four more hips, just side to side. Lovely. Now I want you to put hands on shoulders. And it's like you're literally picking your shoulders up, rolling them back. Or think about elbows kissing. That's another really good analogy. And around they go. So tell me how you go with this format as well. I know it's a bit dodgy being at home, but if you like the length that we do today, or if you'd like something shorter, like 15 minutes, I'd just like to know what's manageable for you. I've got different tutorials of different lengths on here, Facebook, Instagram. So it's just like working out, I think, what works for people in a home environment. It's really different than learning face-to-face. And I just rolled my shoulders the other way. Up to you if you want to do the same. Lovely. We're going to do some big trunk rotations and hip rotations. So it should push your shoulders forward, side, and just roll them out. I know this doesn't look very sexy. We'll do some sexy grinds. These are it. to push forward, and I feel all kinds of little pricks when I do things like this. Just change direction so you feel even. Lovely. And the final couple of exercises we're going to do is just push our hips forward and back. Stretching forward a little bit deeper into the glutes. Yeah, it's not very attractive, is it? So it's like pushing hips forward, bum to the wall behind you. Although I like the taste. And then I'd just love for you to give me a couple of wrist rolls if you'd like to roll ankles, anything like that. Absolutely, you're cool. And now's a great time. If you need a drink of water, grab that. We're going to get into some grinds and a couple of little moves. Because before I go into a routine, I sometimes like to break down a few basic burlesque moves. So we're going to just go through a couple of grinding moves that we're going to use in our routine today. And I just wanted to take a moment first off to break them down a little bit more slowly, and you can put some music on and just flow through it. So it's like you get two mini routines for the price of one, for no price. So a grind, like in the warm-up, we were just rolling our hips around. And I would call that more like a trunk rotation, torso rotation. A real true grind should come around from your pelvis, your vagina, whatever private parts that you have. And it should be imagining that you're drawing a circle from your groin right between your feet. So it comes from your pelvic area, not from your belly button. So instead of pushing out here, you're dropping down here. That's why a soft knee is really crucial, and this could be a bit backwards if you are a dancer and perhaps you're always taught to, you know, stand up straight, straighten your legs. So bend your knees for me just a little bit, and I want you to imagine that you're drawing a circle between your shoes with your pelvis. So just rotate that around for me. And I'm just doing a few circles one way. You can pop hands on thighs. This is really nice for a bit of support. And if you're not getting enough out of it, you don't feel like this move is big enough, bend your knees a bit more. The trick to a good grind is loose knees. And maybe just go the other way. I can guarantee one way will be your good way. So it's important to not just go the good way and to go the other way too. That helps to sort of prevent a little bit of asymmetry in the body. We're all a little bit asymmetrical, but, you know. So this is a really basic grind, and I always say that grinds, this is not a good saying, by the way, it's never going to be printed on a T-shirt. I say that grinds are like eggs. You have one, and then you can do it like 10 different ways. So it's like you can boil, poach, scramble, fry, you know, Florentine, whatever. So that basic grind move will take you so many places. So we're going to play with this one today. Okay, so nice circles. You can add some sexy arms. I love to just trace my arms up and down my body, you know, making my audience feel like they want to be feeling, you know, my soft skin or maybe my snazzy tights. Hopefully if I was on stage, I'd have a bit of costume on. So you can practice just bringing your arms up, down your body. You know, you can go one way, you can go the other way, you can go really quick. So one big arm to a grind. Yes. Lovely. So this is like we're doing a full circle rotation, right? The other way to do a grind is to imagine instead of doing a full circle, doing a half circle or a half moon shape. I usually call this move the pirate ship. If you live in Australia, you'll be really familiar with the big pirate ship ride at Dreamworld, and it's like a big bum swing. So you've got the soft knees, and instead of drawing that circle all the way around, we draw it from side to side, side to side. So it's a little half circle. So if you see me side on, I'm going side, side. Even back on, side. So it's more in the bum. But you'll see I'm still coming from that pelvic area. I'm not pushing out here going side to side. I'm side to side. Yes. So you can just let the arms just be really loose and cool and swing. Maybe push one hip. Just nice, floaty, flowy arms. They should swing out the direction of your hips. So there's two grinds. We've got a circle and a little half circle. We can take that half circle into like a bit of a bigger version, kind of the bend and snap of the burlesque world. So I want you to really bend your knees, twist your bum to the side, and instead of just swinging back, I want you to imagine like someone's pulling you up from your bum crack and lifting you up. So in one full sweep, it's bend, swing, stand, like your chest's coming up. That's a little snap. Let's chest up, bend, chest up, bend, chest up. So it just gives you a little bit more, and you can keep hands on your thighs and see how this gets your upper body involved to a degree. And you could go like really, really low and hit the floor, or you could just go little. Yeah, and I sometimes like to do arms that are like a little choo-choo train to remind me where I'm going. So I'm going choo-choo, choo-choo. It just helps me with my brain. Yeah. So trying to put those three, and then we'll pop some music on. We'll do one more. So remember, we've got our circular grinds. We've got our pirate ship, which is that swing side to side. Then we've got our sort of choo-choo train, bend and snap combination. So we're swinging, swinging. And our fourth one, one, two, three, four, can't count, is a straight-legged half grind. And I like this because if you were facing your bum to the audience, it's like the perfect bum move, where you pop your hands and your thighs and still like you're drawing a half circle, but you're keeping your legs fairly straight and you're bending over a little bit. So from this view, it's like a great booby shot. From the back view, it's a little booby shot, and you can even look over your shoulder a little bit if you feel like it. Okay, so four, not three, really easy grinds for you. So let's pop some music on and do all that together. So we're gonna start with some lots of eight, just to get into the groove a little. So I want you to circle for eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one. Change direction, let's just be even about it. Five, six. Now we're going to go into our pirate ship. One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight. Take it into that choo-choo train motion. Three, four, five, six, seven, eight, straight legs, two, three, four, five, six, last one. Back to the start, let's do lots of four, with some arms, three, four, change it over. Two, three, four, swing, two, three, choo-choo train, one, two, three, four half prime straight legs.
To try. Two, make three. Eyes.
Now make it your own. You go four,
like
four, three, two, change direction. This is just your chance to like feel those grinding movements. Swing it. One, two, three. Big choo-choo. I'm going to make these really deep. Two, three. Straight legs. Make it bigger if you want. Once more, your own style. Two, three, four, other way. Two, three, maybe sit down a bit more, swing it. Choo-choo.
Let's talk about you and me.
Straight legs, and make these really wide. I'd love for you to finish with a
pose.
Beautiful work. Basic grinds, nailed it. So let's pop this into more of a routine where we've got some light and shade and you can have some fun with it. So what I'm going to do is break down each step until we get through our verse and our chorus, and then we'll do it with the music a couple of times, but of course replay this video anytime that you like for as many times as you like until you've got the steps. And the best thing about burlesque is, you know, it's all about you and your style. You don't have to do everything exactly the same as me. It's about finding your rhythm. It's not a ballet class. You don't have to be technically perfect. I would more love for you to be smiling, laughing, having fun, and doing something a little bit different than being in pain. So I'll also show a couple of modifications along the way. So this is the cheesiest song known to man. It's the But I Am a Good Girl song from the burlesque movie, which is a song that is used in the original Crazy Horse Paris, the beautiful stage show there. So I really would recommend looking them up. There is a really incredible performance that has been incorporated into that show with this song that I think is bomb. And it's really different to what you've seen in the movie if that's what you're used to. So definitely check out Crazy Horse for some, I guess, just something different. I don't want to say it's better, it's worse or anything like that. I think it's just different, and it's a great part of your burlesque journey to just uncover different styles of performing. So we're going to start in a classic showgirl position. I always think of this as the I need to do a wee position, because you want your knees locked together. So it's like you're trying to hold in a wee. So your back leg is straight, front leg is bent. You're a little bit turned out with your feet, and your torso is more facing the audience. So you've got a little bit of a line of your body. So we're going to start like this, head high, shoulders back, you know, everything looking amazing. And we're going to start with one arm up, two, three, four, followed by the second arm, two, so six, seven, eight. So on the lyrics, it actually goes, the dress, Chanel, shoes, YSL. So you could make that a little bit more your own. You could go like the dress, Chanel, shoes, YSL. Okay, or you could scoop it up. But that's our first move. And we end up in what's known as the champagne flute pose, because you look like a champagne flute. Beautiful. So try that with me, and then we'll add more on. So we've got the dress is Chanel, the shoes YSL. We're going to take our leg out and our arm out. So we're going to take leg to the side, the bag is Dior, and our arm is going to come out at the same time. So it's going to be the bag is Dior, and then this hand that's raised is going to then come down. And I like palms up to the ceilings. I think it gives me a really elevated line. And if someone quite short, that's what I'm looking for. But you could have palms down. You could bring your hands right down by your sides if your arms are hurting. So from the start, we've got dress Chanel, shoes YSL, bag Dior, Asian provocateur. Lovely. Once more, and then we'll add on. Dress Chanel, shoes YSL, bag Dior, Asian provocateur. We go straight in our legs. Okay, so we're going to come into a straight legged position facing forward. So over here, you probably still had a soft bend in your knee and you were definitely elevated like this, you know, with this leg tapped right out. Perfect. As you straighten your leg, you're going to take one hand to the thigh and then the second hand to your other upper thigh. So from the start, it would be the dress, Chanel, shoes, YSL, bag is Dior, Asian provocateur, my address today. So it's fairly quick. It's 1, 2, 3, 4. Try again and we'll add on. 6, 7, 8. The dress, Chanel, shoes, YSL, bag, Dior, Asian provocateur, address today. We're going to do the straight legged grind. So we're going to go one way, LA by the way. Lovely work. Come back and try that again. The dress, Chanel, shoes, YSL, bag, Dior, Asian provocateur. Address today, LA, by the way. Now we're going to go for a bit of a walk. It doesn't need to be a big walk. If you're like me and you're in your living room or your bedroom, you probably don't have enough room, but it's just going to be a little strut to the side. Because you had your legs pushed a little bit this way because you finished your grind, it's easy to know which way to walk because your weight is on one foot and you should be able to lift the others up. I always think to myself, drag race and point so that I remember what foot and arm is going. And we're basically going to do a sexy grapevine. So I'm on my right foot. You'll be mirroring me at home. So we're going to go 1, 2, cross in front, 3, and just push a bit of weight onto that hip. So for me, I'm stepping onto my right foot. So I'm going right, left, right, a little bit of weight on the right hip. Then I'm going left, right, left, hip. A little bit of a grapevine, yeah? Try that with me. So you've pushed your bum and you've finished over here. So we're going right, left, right, left, right, left. Perfect. If you would like, we can add a little bit of a fancy arm, or you could just pop your hands on your hips. So I'll give you some options. Let's go from the start. So we've got the dress, Chanel, shoes, YSL, bag, Dior, Asian provocateur, address today, LA, by the way, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. If you want, hands on hips, or you can take same arm as leg up and over for like a real showgirl look, and you can even look to your arms. I'll probably be looking at you, but that's okay. You can look towards your arms. So go from the start with the added arms. And we're nearly done with our first verse. How amazing. So we've got dress, Chanel, shoes, YSL, bag, Dior, Asian provocateur, hand to thigh, push our bum, straight legged grind. Then we've got walk, 2, 3, walk, 2, 3. And then I just want you to feel your bum. We should love this move. We're going to step our feet together. I'm going to turn a little bit away from you so that you can see my bum, so that my audience can see my bum. We're going to trace our backs of our legs and all the way back up. You could have legs together. Legs apart gives you more stability. And you can just go down to your knees and back up. You could go all the way to the floor and back up. Like, you can make it look amazing. You can even just go here you know, or down here. And it still looks great. You know, it's not about being the most flexible person, just making it look a way that's comfortable to you. So if you've got tight hamstrings or you're not uber flexible, you know, it looks so much better if you just go down and up and, you know, you look great and you feel great rather than bending all the way down and getting stuck, okay? So you go to your level. I'll try and mix it up a little bit as we go through the routine. So let's try this from the start. 6, 7, 8. Arm up, arm up, leg and arm, arm comes down, hand to thigh, straight leg grind, sexy grapevine, 3, tap, 2, 3, finish it with a little trace of your choice. Okay, so I'll go through that again from the start and then we're going to add one little bit more on to that verse. So remember, starting with that, I need to do a wee position. Dress, Chanel. Shoes, YSL. Bag, Dior. Agent Provocateur. Address today, LA, by the way. And then we're going to go walk, 2, 3, the heels. Mm-hmm. My ring, it's by Winston. It makes their heads twirl. They all say, darling, what did you do for those pearls? That's when we finish, and you know the bit in the lyrics where it goes, what? Boom, 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 boom. I am a good girl. So you could give me a what, like a little facial expression. And then I want you to come in, bring your feet back together, and grab your boob, side of boob, side of boob, and give me like a little squeeze. So you sort of go, what? Boom, 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 boom. Okay, and then you can take your hands up and down your body when she's singing, I am a good girl, or even up and down your body. Okay, so you'll have come up, you'll have traced down all the way up. You'll go, what? Boom, 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 boom. I am a good girl. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay. So you can go, what? If you really don't like the squeeze little thing, you think it looks tacky, it does look tacky, it is a tacky move. You could always go, what? Boom, boom. Just drop your arms and give me just a little shoulder shake. That's totally your choice, yeah? So you can go, what? Boom, 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 boom. I am a good girl. Dun, 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 dun. You know, you just make it your own. So let's try that with some music from the top because I think this is what makes it really fun. And then we're going to add the chorus on, which, you know, there's be some options there. So I think that's quite fun, right? Do it once more with the music. Here we go. Other arm, arm and leg, other arm down, hand to thigh, hand to thigh, walk, 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 walk. So I think that's really, really fun. And we're going to add a chorus on. Okay, so don't say that you don't get a full routine here at Grace Cherry's channel. So you've done your little what? Boom, 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 boom. And you can make that your own. I am a good girl. You could do a little wiggle like I was. You could just go straight up and down. Okay. Either way, it doesn't really matter what foot you start on, because once we get the rhythm, you'll be fine. But I'm going to start with my right foot. Okay. So I'm going to do boom, 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 boom. Hands up and down. And I'm really just doing a little step knee. But because, like you, I might be limited in space, I'm almost doing it on the spot. So I'm going step, bringing my knee up, step, other knee up, okay? And I'm on carpet, so this is going to be interesting compared to when I've done this in the studio. But we're really going step, knee, okay? To make it look even snazzier, if you can lean over a little bit, it looks like super cute. If you go step, knee, and you can get that little Broadway pop. If you're like me and you're on carpet, this might be a bit of a nightmare step. So your alternative is just to go step, tap, and give me that little shoulder pop as well. So it's just like you'd be walking down the aisle, da-da, you know, that little step, tap thing. So you're just going to give me step, tap. Now remember when we did those pirate ship kind of bums? We're going to do two of those. So we're going to swing out, okay? The weight's going back onto our hip. This is the only foot that can move, and we're going to go step, knee, boom, boom, step, knee, boom, boom. Okay, so your weight's always here. For me, I'm singing to my left. My right leg is going to pick up. You could change direction each time. You know, it doesn't really matter too much. And if you are like you're getting caught on the floor or something, just give me step. Ba-da-da-da. And if like me, you're short on space, my little sneaky trick is to go step, knee. And as I swing, I sort of step back a little bit. Okay, so I'm not traveling as much. Three. So there's three of these. Step, knee, swing it. After the third one, we're just going to take a little walk back. So you could turn around. Boom. But I really love to just walk backwards and to just do a little shimmy. Then we repeat. So we go back to step, knee, swing it, step, knee, or even step, tap, swing it, ba-ba-da-da-da. 5, 6, 7, 8. Okay, so let's try that from the very start without the music. Okay, so we've got dress, Chanel, shoes, YSL, feet and arm out, arm down, straight leg, hand, push our bum with that little straight leg grind, walking, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 3, and then we've got our trace. Check your bum out. Great bum, everyone. And then you've got your little what? Boom, 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 boom. Oh, boom, 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 boom. I am a good girl. 2, 3, 4, 6, 7, 8. Right foot or your foot. Step, knee. Swing it. Step, knee, swing it, or even a little step, tap, swing it, walk back, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, then it repeats. So we've got three of those knee dip combos. Last one. Dip, swing, swing. Dun, 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 dun. A 5, 6, and 8. And cleverly, we're back in our starting position and we'll do the whole routine again. So it runs through completely twice, which is really fun because sometimes you don't get it the first time around. You think, oh, damn, I missed that. So you've got another round to do it, okay? So let's walk through it again and then we'll do it with the music maybe 2 times through, one time where I'll yell out the steps and the second time where I'll just do it to the music so you can kind of see the pacing. Then you can do it as many times as you want. Okay, so legs together. We start 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Arm and leg, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. And we walk. 2, and up, and back. Da, 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 da. You've got as much time as you want to trace down. Wide legs, legs together, doesn't matter to me. Then you've got your facial expression. What? 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 Boom, 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 boom. I am a good girl. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Then we start that knee up. Knee up. Swing it. Swing it. Knee up. Swing it. You can do your own arms. And remember, these could just be little walks, little taps. Shimmy back. A 5, 6, 7, 8, and that repeats. Swing, swing, that repeats for 2. Swing, and last one. Knee, knee, swing, swing, back. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Back to the start. So let's do that with the music. I'll yell stuff out this time, and then we'll do it with the music. Where I'll just kind of perform it for you and, yeah, and then you've got some kind of cues and things to follow along. I think this is kind of fun, right? And then you like the steps as we go this time.
Transition now.
I know there's someone that does those t-shirts that say, but I am a rich man, mum. And I really need one of those. So I'm going to do that with the music, and you're going to follow along with me and just sort of get some ideas about how you can just make it your own, put a little bit more personality into it. Like I said, you could bring your knees up on that little chorus, but if you feel like you're falling over, just do little taps. You see how I still popped my shoulders and tried to make it look like snazzy? You know, you could do four little swings. You can do extra, yeah, just make it your own. So this is the fun time, okay? Every time's a fun time, but this is just the chef's kiss. So come with me from the start. And I'm just gonna walk through it.
The dress is Chanel, the shoes for yourself, the bag is Dior, it's a provocateur. My address today, LA by the way, above Sunset Strip, the hills all the way. My ring's on my Webster, it makes the heads twirl. They all say, darling, what did you do for those pearls? What? I am a good girl.
Routine. So let me know what you think, and if this length of time is a good one for you, 40 to 45 minutes, if you'd like more like half an hour or 20 minutes, if that's more manageable for you, please let me know. Or if you're kind of stuck at home or there's nowhere in your area that knows or can teach you little burlesque tricks like boa or chair or fans, just comment below. And I'm really happy to throw some of that into our regular little Friday series. Otherwise, please give me a little thumbs up, ring the subscribe little bell thing, and that way you won't miss another Burlesque at Home with me. And there's also a link below to my subscription service, which is with a company called Buy Me a Coffee, kind of what it says on the tin, for the price of a cup of coffee. Like one cup of coffee. So about $4 for the month keeps me being able to make content for you. So if you can subscribe, do it. If not, please just thumbs the video up, share it with a friend. Even better, bring a friend over if that's safe for you where you are in the world at the moment, and do this routine together. I'd love that. And just have a giggle. Have a good night, everyone. Have a good Friday. Have a good rest of your week. See you next time. Bye.